Come to order, please. Good afternoon, welcome to the Commissioner St. Mary's County meeting this date, Tuesday, January 19th, 2016. I am Randy Guy, President of the Commissioner St. Mary's County. I'd introduce the other four commissioners standing on this table, Representative First Commissioner District, which includes Ridge, Piney Point, St. George's Island, Commissioner Tom Jarboe.
Good afternoon.
Representing Second Commissioner District, which includes Leonardtown, Hollywood, Commissioner Mike Hewitt.
Good afternoon.
And sitting to this side, on the other side of the table here, is Representative Third Commissioner District, which includes Charlotte Hall, Seventh District, Golden Beach, Commissioner John O'Connor.
Afternoon.
And sitting next to him, Representative Fourth Commissioner District, which includes Lexington Park, some of California Great Mills, Commissioner Todd Morgan. Sitting next to Commissioner Morgan, at the end of the table, is Dr. Bridget, our County Administrator.
Good afternoon.
On my immediate right is Sharon Ferris, our Recorder, and Ms. Amy Carter, who's our videographer, is behind the glass. Please turn off your cell phone, off or on vibrate. When you come to the microphone or representative table, please approach by coming down the center aisle. Remember, this meeting is being televised, so you need to speak clearly and directly into the microphone for recording purposes. We will be holding a public hearing on Code Home Rule tonight at 6:30 p.m. at the Bay District Fire Department. The invocation of pledge will be done by Commissioner O'Connor today.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this gathering, and we thank you for the blessings upon us, for our family, friends. Pray for those that are being affected by this cold, our veterans, and those who are without, and that your blessings be upon them, and that they may find some place of comfort among us, and that those that are there to help when we have that extending, reaching hand towards them and your spirit. We pray for guidance and the wisdom that you bestow upon us to be leaders and lead for others and not for our own intentions. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Commissioner O'Connor. And next, we'll need the approval of the minutes of January 12th.
I move to approve the minutes of January 12th, 2016, as presented.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Ayes have it. We'll now turn it over to our County Administrator, Dr. Bridget.
Thank you, Commissioner President Guy. First on your agenda today is to look at your draft meeting agendas for the next 2 weeks. On January 26th, next Tuesday, you begin at 8:30 in the morning with your annual reception for your volunteer members of the Commissioners of St. Mary's County's boards, commissions, and committees. That's held here in the lobby of the Chesapeake Building. Your regular business meeting starts at 9 with the recognition of the volunteer members of boards, commissions, and committees. Then, following your regular business meeting that morning, you have an executive session scheduled tentatively at 10:15 a.m. to review personnel and real property. On Tuesday, February 2nd, you have your regular business meeting beginning at 9 a.m. here in the Chesapeake Building. For today's business meeting, we begin with the county attorney with the renewal of the lease to Newtown Players, Inc. George Sparling presenting. Good morning, or good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Sorry I wasn't able to join you this morning. I'm sure it was a delightful temperature.
It was rather refreshing standing out in the cold.
This is a matter of some housekeeping that you may recall back in September when you had your meeting with the Board of Education. One of the actions that was taken was to approve a set of maps that set 1,000-foot boundaries around counties, high schools and secondary schools for use in the event.
Excuse me, Mr. Sparling, this is the Newtown lease renewal. Your second item is the drug-free school zone. So if you don't mind, I'm sure they have Newtown lease in front of them. If it's not too much trouble, we'll ask you to begin with that. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Well, I'll save some talk on the next one. This is also a housekeeping matter. Some time ago, the county leased the old Lexington Park Library to the Newtown Players, a community theater organization. The lease provided for notice of their desire to renew, followed by the county's agreement to renew. And we have that here before you today. Talked to the Department of Public Works and Transportation Mr. Erickson. Apparently, there are no issues with the building, no issues with the tenancy. Would suggest that might be appropriate, if the board's so inclined, to renew, give them notice of we accept their renewal.
Mr. Sparling, I'm not sure if it's up your bailiwick to answer this question, but this is to AQs. And we hear that they only want 50 people per acre down there. Does a theater like this, that, I mean, I went to probably two plays so far since they've been there, but there was well over 60 people both times I went. And I wonder how that plays into it. It can be 60 people or more for 2 hours every once in a while, or do you know how that works as far as that 60 people per acre or 50 people per acre?
I'm going to plead ignorance. I could ask Mr. Shire to explain that to me. My suspicion is that when they're talking about 50 people, they're talking about on a recurring or irregular basis, whereas this would be a crowd of numbers such as you refer to only on a periodic and a very short-term basis.
It's the reason you can't have that school back there, but we can use it for a recreational facility. Because when they have soccer games going, they have more than 50 people, too. That's internal soccer.
The rule of thumb has been is that when you take into consideration adults have an ability to decide and judge for themselves where they will be. And we've discussed putting office spaces in there in the past. Offices become more permanent in nature on the fact that an adult is going in there. But with the Newtown Neck thing, the way it's always generally been considered, since it's always a temporary part-time thing and it's generally taking place at night, which is outside the flying hours generally, it's a permissible use.
Well, I know there was a person who came and said they thought that area would be good for like an amphitheater type of thing to, because they talked about, Vicki Vogue from Lex Leader. She is now the new, I guess, executive director of the CDC. And she had approached me about doing some type of an art park in that area along with some kind of an amphitheater to hold events that could, attract people to that area.
Yeah. She and Watts have been on that one for a while.
Point is, you think that's allowed there?
The question is, I don't know the answer to that one. I think there's two sides. There's what our land use people would say, which would be Mr. Shire, and then with the Navy's position would be going back to the TEC to allow that to take place. If you remember when that whole piece of property was subdivided, the northern piece, which is the closest where the Newtown Neck is where a proposed townhouse center was supposed to go in, and it did fall outside the ACUS APZ because the runway, there's a fine line in there somewhere down around like where Erie Insurance is in there, that building. So north was okay for a townhouse condominium by rule. The southern part down towards where the runway wasn't. It always gets into that fine line where, does the airplane fly in a straight line or can it deviate over the line? So that's the reason that the county has always pretty much taken the conservative approach to leave everything up there just as bare as possible to protect the ACUS APZ areas of the base.
Okay. I'll assume you don't know.
That's a safe assumption.
Okay.
Would you like me to find out?
If they allow an amphitheater down there, then these people can start looking forward. I told them I didn't think it was going to be allowed because of the AQs, and they said, you get the theater, you get the town theater, they do the same thing. They attract a bunch of people at one time. But if that was, if they could put an amphitheater down there, maybe we could tell them what they can and can't do.
Are you referring to the
Old flat top property. The memorial for the African American soldiers and whatnot.
Yes.
We have that one building there.
Right.
And it just seems like if we had more activity in that area, whether it be an amphitheater or whatever it would be, that we could have more activity down there of a positive nature.
They were proposing that on the post office side, going down the street there.
And I think, as you were referring to, that the property is divided into two sections.
The north and south parcels.
Actually, one of which was proposed for some development a couple of years ago.
And then that's the north parcel where the old library currently sits.
Anyway, they have this idea of an art park where they have outside art and have a theater, of an amphitheater of some type where they could have concerts and stuff. That's what they were talking about.
might be a matter, I don't know whether that's something Mr. Lowy might be more appropriately looking into.
We certainly can follow up.
Okay.
If you'd like us to, Commissioner Hewitt.
Yeah, just so I can tell Vicki Wilken.
Okay.
I think I agree with Todd on that. I think it's mainly for a permanent type of these temporary things. I don't think it really matters that much.
Okay.
But I understand. I don't think it does. But, yes, sir, that's fine.
I move to approve the renewal of the lease of 21744 Coral Place, Lexington Park, Maryland, to Newtown Players, and can authorize the Office of the County Attorney to so advise the Newtown Players.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Ayes have it.
Thank you, Commissioners. And next on the agenda is to appoint your 2016 Vice President for St. Mary's County Commissioners. The purpose, of course, is that annually you appoint your vice president, usually that coincides with your district. So District 1 was last year, Commissioner Jarboe served, and so to stay with tradition, we are proposing District 2, Commissioner Hewitt for this morning. And there's a motion for your proposed for you. And also in board docs, we have put together a chart that says annually what your term is and what you're appointed to, and so we'll update that as you'd like us to, but it just keeps it all in one place.
Since I'm outgoing, I'll make the motion.
You sure?
Yeah. I'm going to hand it to you, Mike.
No, no.
I move to appoint Michael L. Hewitt, District 2, to serve as Vice President for the Commissioners of St. Mary's County for 2016.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed?
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
Ayes have it.
Thank you, Commissioners. And this concludes County Administrator time. And back on your main agenda is a resolution to approve drug-free school zone map for Captain Walter Francis Duke Elementary School. George Sparling, County Attorney, presenting. Mr. Sparling.
As I was saying. When you approve the school drug zone maps for the county in September, as a matter of fact, I think the question was raised at the meeting when that was being formulated, the Captain Walter Francis Duke School had not yet opened, and we did have Luggum prepare a map, and we proposed to you today a resolution to supplement the prior resolution by including Captain Walter Francis Duke School.
I move to adopt the resolution to approve a drug-free school zone map for Captain Walter Francis Duke Elementary School.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Ayes have it. Thank you, George.
Thank you very much.
The witness may be excused.
Okay, with that being done, let's see. We're now down to commissioner's time. We'll start with Commissioner Morgan first.
Mr. President, due to an extenuating circumstance, I'll be missing this evening's Code Home Rule meeting in Bay District.
Okay.
A little tidbit for all those that recycle out there. There's been a lot of issues with plastic bags going into the recycling business. This may sound trivial when you go to the grocery store, you get your recycling bag, and we're really, really happy you're recycling. But when it gets up to Baltimore and they start to use the machines to crunch it, those plastic bags are really starting to mess the machines up. So what they're asking now is that when you come to recycle, the each of the transfer stations will have a plastic bin there. So if you just put all your plastic bags into the bin, we'll take them and get them recycled properly. But please don't keep putting those plastic bags into the dumpster, because it's messing up the other end of the operation. So that was that. And thank you for everybody wishing me a happy 60th birthday. It was great. I went to watch the basketball game with my kids. Came home, watched football. So happy 60th. Thank you.
Got to attend the Mechanicsville Volunteer Fire Department installation. Of course, it was off-site this year as they're under construction. They're home away from home. I'm looking forward to next year attending in their new fire department and banquet hall. I actually got to sit. It was a packed house, so I sat with the actual architectural and engineering firm and got to hear about all the details that actually went into what it took to actually get that building going from their point of view. It was very interesting. It was a great event and well attended, and you could definitely tell there's a strong community up there, and they're very supportive of each other and families. I do want to thank the Airport Advisory Board
Mr. George Erickson and his team, the FAA, Mr. Buildman, and everybody down there at St. Mary's Airport for accomplishing the mission of getting the Albatross Grumman HU-16 down here. It wasn't an easy feat. There was a lot of work that went into that, a lot of support, a lot of coordination that had to happen, but it's huge for the county and for the businesses that are located down here, and it will help support, hopefully support missions at Pax River. So I'm really happy about that, and I'm looking forward to actually getting down there and seeing it fly, because I have never got a chance to see one of those in action actually flying around. And I'm also like to say that the new flight school that's down there is great, amazing. I had a chance to actually get up for all 0.4 hours before the bay fog rolled in and we had to land. But the flight instructors are great, the planes are great, and they're doing a great job down there overall. I know I said three greats in one sentence about the flight school, but they really are. They're doing a great job, and I can't say enough about them. I would like to ask everyone if they could you know, just keep my family in their thoughts and prayers. You know, it seems that cancer is one of those that likes to go ahead and find its way into various different areas. But some of my family members have recently been diagnosed with cancer. Hopefully it's curable. We'll find out. But the one thing I can say is to the women that are out there, you know, it's not a joke. If your insurance company allows it, don't skip a mammogram. Make sure you get out there, get tested early. If it runs in your family, make sure you get out there early and fight your insurance company and get tested early. You know, you don't want to lose your life because you skipped the test. So, and that's not the case here. I'm just encouraging it to get out there and get tested and make sure that you get tested, because that's exactly what happened here. It was an early test and it caught it early, and hopefully they'll be able to save one of my family members' lives. So just keep us in your thoughts and prayers, and I'll keep you updated, and hopefully we'll see what happens. So other than that, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. I joined Commissioner O'Connor at the Mechanicsville Fire Department installation the other night, and a couple things really struck me. Having been in the EMS and fire community, I understand how tightly connected that community is. It was sad to note that this past year, they lost seven of their members in 1 year. That's a lot. But it also goes to show that there's an aging workforce in the fire and rescue community. So it's something that I'd ask the younger generation to really look at stepping up and helping out. To the Burroughs, Wenk, Kenny Burroughs, Eddie Wood, and Lucy Stash, and Buddy Adams, and Harold Younger families, our condolences from the board, and thank you for your service of your family members. Build up a little bit on what John was talking about at the airport. Other good things that are happening. University of Maryland test site. I don't know when they're doing their grand opening, but it's complete. I've done a walkthrough over there, and it is an amazing facility. So that's just one beginning of how much we want to expand business operations, maybe some incubation acceleration around autonomous systems over at the airport. So, Dr. Bridget, do you know when the grand opening is scheduled?
I have not heard, but I'll check.
I know they have a business after hours coming up here next month, so it must be in between there somewhere. But anyway, we'll find out, and we'll make sure the public knows, because this is a big deal for our community. Thank you.
Mike. Okay, thank you. First thing I want to talk about is something I think is important, and it's called the Patuxent River Commission. I'm a member to that commission. I was appointed. The commissioners put my name up, and the governor appointed me. We had a meeting last week. And what was brought up was the rain tax. We all know that the rain tax has been compromised along the idea that the state will not require a fee to be paid, i.e. a rain tax. But they did keep in the legislation that their communities, counties will have to come up with programs, plans to reduce load management. The Patuxent River Commission is made up, of course, St. Mary's County, Calvert County, Charles County, PG County, and even gets up into Montgomery County. So it's quite an eclectic group. It's mostly represented by people from, I use the term, up the road, PG, Montgomery, and there's a lot of individuals involved. What they came up with in a vote of 20-3, I was one of the three, is they're going to go before the delegation, not the delegation, but the legislature this year, and they're going to insist that counties have to come up with a mechanism to pay for their part of this WIP, i.e. another rain tax. They're going to insist that the Montgomery County, which has gotten back to a tax, and they were happy that a tax has been reinstalled in Montgomery County, that PG County is not calling it a tax, it's going to call it a fee. But they're going to want the other counties that are associated with the Patuxent River to come up with a mechanism to pay for the mitigation of the load nutrients that we have to reduce. That's a little alarming to me given the governor we have. What I thought was interesting is the other two people who voted against this motion was the person from the Maryland Department of Planning, David Craig's appointment person there, and also the person from DNR. Again, I think it's Secretary Belden's appointment to that board. All three of us thought it was in direct contrast to what the governor has tried to work out with the legislature. So we need to keep an eye on the Patuxent River Commission. Secondly, I did attend the Leonardtown Volunteer Rescue Squad installation this past weekend, and it was a great affair, well attended. Again, the thing that strikes me in all these installations, whether they're rescue squad, volunteer fire department, even the farm banquet, is the it gets in these people's blood, this volunteerism, this wanting to help other people. And thank God we have them. I told them that night, and I'll tell them every chance I get, we can't thank them enough. We can't praise them enough. There's not enough we can do to tell them how valuable they are. So it's very important that we say thank you at a minimum. Now, lastly, on a personal note, my granddaughter, Maddie Rose, when she heard I was talking about her the last meeting, watched it on YouTube. My daughter actually brought it up. So we watched it together. And when I talked that she had abandoned these meetings for Paw Patrol and Hello Kitty, Baby Einstein, she said, "Papa, no, that's not true." She said, "I'm in school now." On Tuesday, she has preschool from 9 o'clock to noon. So I stand corrected. Thank you, Maddie Rose. Secondly, Sloan Michelle, 4 weeks old today, getting stronger. Come on, Sloaney, we're waiting for you. Thank you.
Hang on, an apology from Commissioner?
Hey, look, what can I do? I was wrong.
Okay, bring it up. And for I know John already brought about a cancer in his own family, and very true. My wife had breast cancer at 49 years old, so it's very important you get screened. No doubt about it. Myself, I'm doing very well. I have 3 more days of radiation. This radiation is almost as bad as the damn chemo, but oh well, it's what it is. You got to do to fight this stuff. But I got 3 more days left, and hopefully things will turn around. Everything will get better after a while here, but I'm doing okay. Also, once again, on the volunteerism, I went to the Mechanicsville Rescue Squad, not this past last week, and they're right about the elders carrying the load. The 3 top performers, I hate to say it, were in their 70s. Unbelievable. The top guy had 560 calls last year, and he's 74 years old, and he performed 560 calls. Unbelievable. So we're definitely in dire need of people to volunteer and get yourself out there if you can. So if you got the urge to be an EMT or a fireman or even driving the they have special, like for the ambulances, they have drivers only. You don't have to be an EMT certified. So whatever you can do to volunteer, I appreciate it, especially in the evenings. I understand the problem they have really is nighttime. It's the worst time to try to get people to respond. And, of course, coming tomorrow, we start, like I said, the legislative process. You already heard the news started. And we, the county commissioners, all the counties and the city of Baltimore, respond up there every Wednesday, what they call MACO. That's the Maryland Association of Counties. And I'm going to be this year on the Education Committee and the Legislative Committee starting tomorrow morning. And we meet every Wednesday. Commissioner Jarvis is my second man in charge. He's going to be going up quite often.
And I'm on land use, so people know that.
He's on the land use committee. So, and these are very important things. We get some insight. These legislation up there usually relates to the entire state of Maryland, but our input as both a rural county and I quite often I have to say that the suburban counties have a big whip, you might say, but we're up there making a voice for Southern Maryland or St. Mary's County, and it is very important that we go up there every week. Because these things do relate to us in the end. These bills and legislations passed, and they're not just passed for Montgomery County. Half the time, it's just as important for us to be there as everybody else. So we'll be starting this. Just let you know that we, the commissioners, also participate in the entire legislative process the whole time it's going on. Other than that, I have nothing else to say except thanks. I'm getting better. No, I'm not getting better yet, but hopefully very soon after Friday, I'll start getting better. Nothing else, except one more announcement. They got a public hearing tonight, Code Home Rule, at the 46900 South Shangri-La Drive, Lexington Park, Maryland. That's the Bay District Volunteer Fire Department. Now adjourned.